That's not just a deal, son. That's a meal.
Surely old Burger King never gets into the car business.
Because I'm working too close to the bone.
Burger King, get your burgers worth.
At last, satellite television has come down to Earth with PrimeStar. PrimeStar offers you a wealth of family entertainment, pro and college sports, the latest hit movies, all with digital quality picture and sound. Best of all, you don't have to buy the dish. PrimeStar is a service, so you get great programming, the use of all equipment, even maintenance, all starting at about a dollar a day. All you have to do is call 1-800-PRIMESTAR.
Courtney Hall, the offensive quarterback of the offensive line.
Tuesday, the pigskin party continues.
I can fix this.
See how the Taylors enjoy the Super Bowl.
Touchdown! Who needs a big screen TV, huh?
It's Home Improvement. Then Grace meets a super guy.
You know, I think it's high time we took our relationship to the next level.
Here? Now?
Grace under fire after Home Improvement Tuesday on ABC.
The 22nd Annual American Music Awards comes your way tomorrow here on ABC. Great performances by a lot of stars, and an award to be presented by Deion Sanders, who will make his way to L.A. and then on to Hawaii for the Pro Bowl next week. You know, we were talking about the Niners and keeping their team together, and they have a lot of their key people under contract. Sanders signed a one-year deal for Bowl. Tomorrow on Good Morning America, Super Bowl heroes, key players from tonight's game on Good Morning America, and a look at the winners from the Battle of the Super Bowl commercials on Good Morning America tomorrow. I guess when you win a Super Bowl, it's easy to get up at that hour and join Charlie and Joan and the gang.
I'm not sure you have to get up.
You go straight over there. You're right.
You do it on the way home.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
I don't think getting up's a problem.
Yep.
You're just looking for a place to bed down about that time.
Wednesday.
I'm pregnant, I don't feel good, and I'm tired. It's the only way I can get a break.
The Connors go crazy when the doctor keeps Rosie in bed.
Happy now?
No, my foot's blocking my view.
On an all-new Roseanne, then Ellen's dumped by a blind date.
You can be honest with me. I mean, we're grown-ups.
On Ellen.
Your mom told my mom that you said that I was weird.
Wednesday on ABC.
Do you feel safe behind your locked door? Don't bet your life on it. Robbery, assault, or even worse. What some landlords don't want you to know, 2020 investigates Friday.
Scott Cash, part of the spirit of Hampton Roads.
This is the Ford Explorer postgame report.
It's the event you've waited for. The Prize Patrol is live in Phoenix, Arizona, where moments ago we surprised Marianne Brandt.
Marianne?
Yes.
Could you come here, please?
Yes.
Marianne, you've just won $10 million from Publishers Clearinghouse. All of America's watching. What have you got to say?
$10 million.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
It's the...
Jeez, I had... What?
Strange Occurrence in Smithfield, Thursday at 6. Live from Super Bowl 29, this is the Ford Explorer postgame report.
Coming up next, you'll meet a whole new group who will make this the hottest winter ever. It's the special preview of Extreme. New on ABC, starting right after our postgame coverage next. This...
Do you feel safe behind your locked door? Don't bet your life on it. Robbery, assault, or even worse.
I never was concerned that if I locked my door, I would be raped.
What some landlords don't want you to know. A 2020 undercover investigation, Friday.
You gotta be bad, you gotta be bold, you gotta be wiser. You gotta be cool, you gotta be calm, you gotta stay together.
Well, tomorrow on Good Morning America, Super Bowl heroes, key players from tonight's game. Also tomorrow, a look at the winners from the Battle of the Super Bowl commercials. Plus, Whoopi Goldberg on tomorrow's Good Morning America, right here on ABC.
This has been a presentation of ABC Sports, recognized around the world as the leader in sports television.
It's the hottest winter ever. Welcome to the Edge. The winter heats up next with Extreme on ABC.
Being a U.S. Marshal is not what you call a 9-to-5 job. But you do get to meet a lot of interesting people.
The Marshal. Special preview Tuesday on ABC.
Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of Widget and Pop Top. I'm Widget, and with me as always is my good pal, Pop Top.
What's going on, my peoples?
We're getting ready to watch the big game, but first, we need to make sure we have all the snacks we're gonna need. Okay, we got a large pizza with everything on it.
Check.
Nachos.
El Checo.
Bean dip for said nachos.
Yucca.
And last but not least, buffalo wings with extra blue cheese, extra spicy.
Check, check, and ouch.
All right, we're ready to watch the big game. Let's do this.
Hey, we forgot the guacamole.
Just use the bean dip.
You eat the bean dip.
What's wrong with the bean dip?
It looks the same going in as it does coming out.
Ew.
I'm not eating it.
Ugh, fine. Okay, let's try this again. Large pizza with everything on it.
Molto bene.
Nachos?
Si, por favor.
Bean dip for said nachos.
Gah.
Buffalo wings with extra blue cheese. Extra spicy.
Feel the burn, baby.
And finally, last but not least, fresh guacamole.
Hola.
Green goo.
Now we're finally ready to watch the game.
Dude! Barbecue chips.
Damn it!
Ooh, maybe in some onion dip too.
Okay, one more time. Large pizza with everything on it.
Ciao.
Nachos.
Si.
Bean dip for nachos.
Nope.
Buffalo wings with extra blue cheese. Extra spicy.
Spicy meatball.
Fresh guacamole.
Muy importante.
Hola.
And finally, barbecue chips with onion dip.
It's good because it rhymes.
Now, is there anything else we may have forgotten?
No, I think we're good.
Good. Then let's watch the game.
Yes, please. Dude, we forgot the beer.
Son of a...
You kissed your mother with that mouth?
For the last time, large pizza with everything on it.
Present.
Nachos.
Presento.
Bean dip.
None in your life.
Buffalo wings. Extra blue cheese. Extra spicy.
Ay, ay, ay.
Fresh guacamole.
Green and lovely.
Barbecue chips with onion dip.
So good you'll flip.
And finally, a nice cold 12-pack of delicious beer.
The precious.
Now, I don't care if we missed anything else. We're done. Can we just watch the game now?
Hear, hear.
All right.
And that's gonna do it for all of us here at the big game. We now send it live back to our studios in Los Angeles for more post-game report. Good night, and we'll see you next season for more NFL action.
Hey, do you wanna just go get some Froyo?
Froyo?
Yeah.
Really?
Yes.
We went all over town, amassing this amazing plethora of snack food, and you just wanna go get Froyo?
Well, what do you want me to do with the food now? It's cold and gross.
All right.
Awesome. I'm gonna get some sprinkles, man.
You want to talk about deals? You just set yourself down. Now, real deal, it calls to you. Do you hear that? See, Burger King's got this burger. It's a thing of beauty. The Whopper. Hello, Betty. Hey, oh my God.
Yeah.
That should have worked.
I still hear music, Jeff.
I know, because the stream hasn't caught up. Hold on.
But we gotta let it finish itself naturally.
There we go. All right, I figured it out. Now the problem here. There
we go. Explain the problem.
Thank you, Hocus. The problem is I had to minimize this thing because mm-hmm. One of our monitors died mm-hmm. right before the show, and so I'm missing my source. My sources. There we go.
Oh, hey, there we are.
All right. Now.
Hey, look at those two handsome guys.
Now. Watch what happens if I put Miles back on. Which one is it? Let me see. All right, ready? Turn it down. All right. And then it's done. Okay, it shouldn't be on anymore. We shouldn't hear it. All right, how's that sound? Does that sound okay? I think that sounds okay. Monitor off. Let me mute. Thanks, Miles. All right, so that's one of our youngest fans, Mr. Miles. Hey, Wabba. Well, welcome, Wabba. We haven't seen you in a while. Welcome to the chat, Wabba.
So Uh-Oh is officially on our staff now as our QC.
Uh-Oh will be paid in bits. Bits of plenty. And there's other perks being part of our staff, I think. We do annual company trips to Hershey Park in Hershey, Pennsylvania.
Yep.
Where you'll have all the chocolate.
All expenses paid to Hershey, Pennsylvania.
Unfortunately, it's no expenses paid.
No expenses paid to.
But we will call the Board of Tourism before we go. And I'm sure we can set up a tour of some kind of the post office.
We'll throw in a bar, too.
The local McDonald's.
We're not savages.
We will go to a bar.
We'll put a whole bar of Hershey's chocolate on your pillow.
Mm,
for the hotel room that you paid for.
Oh, and
we'll actually break into the hotel you paid for to put that on your pillow.
Exactly.
Yeah.
We will. It'll happen. You'll get a pound of chocolate on your pillow.
Yeah.
It'll probably be a little melty by the time you go to bed.
Well, yeah, because we got to smuggle it in.
Yeah, so it'll be very melty and kind
your
of
imagination.
Warped.
Yeah.
All right. It won't exactly look like chocolate, and in the middle of the night, you may be in for a start. If you turn on the light suddenly and notice a big gelatinous brown mold of sorts.
And that just means the shrooms are kicking in.
That probably means you had a good night. If you see worms coming out or maybe a dragon of some sort. But otherwise, it's chocolate and it's perfectly edible. Hey, I'm rooting for the 49ers just because who else? I don't know. I don't feel much for the KC Chiefs.
Yeah.
I don't know. Are they in KCK or are they in KC Mo? I don't know. I don't know what state. They straddle states. They're very, very off-putting for me anyway. It's like...
whatever. 49ers! 49ers!
So, it was...
Well, I'll tell you, Jeff, it's going to be a big game.
Oh, here we go.
It's going to be a big game.
Ladies and gentlemen,
I got the sports blades are going. It's going to be a big game on Sunday. Everybody's excited.
Yes,
you know? Oh, wait, cut to the right background.
This is sport.
Did you load that one up?
Hold on. No, all we have is the wheel background. But hey, this is pretty. You can do interviews from here. That's what I thought you were
Because this is the same as the stinky locker room.
Yeah. Hold on. I can do it. You talk.
Okay. Well, it's going to be a big game, everybody, on Sunday. We're all excited. There's going to be wings, and there's going to be beer, and who cares about anything else, because that's what we're going to have. Back to you, Jeff.
Wow, that gave me no time to do anything.
Well, come on.
I didn't even...
What do we pay you for?
You don't. And I tell you, I was supposed to have wings. You were supposed to actually be oh, I see I got a new blazer.
Can we talk about the fact that... This is my sportscaster outfit.
Oh, what a lovely blue blazer you have.
That is a very sharp blazer, but it looks like you had a lobotomy.
Well, no, I'm wearing a toupee.
Oh!
Yeah, so...
Right. It's rich man lobotomy,
what's left of Marv Albert.
Okay.
It's what's left. Oh, man. That's disturbing.
Back to you, Jeff.
All right, thank you.
He just wants to say back to you, Jeff.
Uh-oh. Anonymous wasted 10 bits, guys. It's a death fish.
What?
He's somewhere here in the basement. We're flooded. Oh, my God. All right, hold on. Hold on. Where is he? He's going to get one of us. Right. Oh, God, we're Mechanodon. No! Oh, no! No, not again. No, Mechanodon.
Oh, my God!
We got to let this play out.
This thing's got my feet!
All right,
oh, my God! Oh, shit!
He does it so well.
Ah!
You're safe, my friend.
Son of a bitch.
You're safe from that beast.
The jaws in that thing.
Oh, thank you, Anonymous.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my gosh, for alerting us to that death fish.
Well, I'm going to let you guys be alone for a minute.
All right. Come back and interview some sports legends in a moment. Oh, my gosh. We got to recover from this near-death incident.
Oh, my God.
Anonymous, thank you very much. You alerted us.
Maybe it was attracted to the toupee, you think?
Well, toupees are known to attract predators of all shapes.
I think so. I think that's what they eat.
Especially
in the
ocean.
They're a natural toupee predator.
Yeah. The scent, the oils from the toupee just kind of bleed out through the sea and attract whale sharks, normal sharks, tortoises that somehow are in the ocean.
Is that so?
Yes. Yes. All right.
Our readers want to know.
You're back. Our readers want to know. You have a microphone.
Well, our watchers want to know.
What medium do you broadcast in, sir? All right, what do we want to know? What's it? Well, all right, I'm ready for the big game. All right.
Back to you, Jeff.
I told you.
He's an award-winning sports broadcaster, ladies and gentlemen. Joe Rice to Joey Montana for a field goal. 4 points.
He's so serious, he taped that microphone to his hand.
I love it.
He sleeps with it.
All right, Chad, you got to give me, because I played a Super Bowl. We're going to talk about all sorts of things tonight. But
Super Bowl.
But Super Bowl is definitely top of the list. Coming up, big games this Sunday. Now, I played a big game,
Jeff. Everybody's excited.
I played a thing at the office, right? One of those checkerboards.
Oh, you played a pool. You
played
a pool.
Where you pick a square.
What's the prize?
I don't know. Well, money.
It's called squares.
Oh,
it's called squares, yeah. You get all... Thank you, studio audience. It's true. It's called squares. And
our on-site gambling expert.
Yeah. But I don't know if I played it right, because it was empty, and it didn't have any of the scores yet, so I didn't know what to pick. So I just picked the center square. And I have no idea if that is a smart move, or it would just generate, like, the most unlikely score in football history. Like, maybe the four-point game. Uh-oh, because this is talking about there.
Well, we'll see. We're going to send it back to the studio now, and... Jeff's not going to talk about gambling anymore. Maybe. I don't know. It's a big weekend. It's a big game on Sunday, Jeff. Everyone's excited.
Yeah.
As I said.
What are we supposed to talk about?
You know. Back to you, Steve.
Circle gets the center square, says Wabba plays. Thank you, Wabba. That gives me confidence.
Back to you, Steve.
All right.
That's close enough.
Shia.
That's Shia.
Back to you, Shia.
Like, we're limited.
We could... Sehr ruhig, ihr Leute. Gebraucht Verstand. Unser Leben ist bedroht. Hilf uns niemand, droht uns Not. Und ihr Menschen werdet nie mehr glücklich sein.
I don't know. I don't think it's ever too early.
Come on, Dizzy.
Or D-Woody.
D-Woody.
That's my...
I'm going to go take this blazer off.
Super Bowl hero.
Are we done with this bit?
I don't know. It's a gift that keeps on giving.
I guess.
Keep it on.
It's a good segue. We'll end every segment with it. Well, back to you, Steve.
Back to you, Steve, because we also need you to be the game show host, and that's
true.
Kind of a dual outfit you got going
Game
on.
Break!
Unless
I wish I had a Bob Barker mic.
It's close. You have a nice...
I mean,
it's a pretty good
piece of foam on top of a PVC mic.
It's,
so,
it's
you know,
serviceable.
We're doing well on this, Joe. We got the budget going.
We do. Hey, look, Anonymous gave us 10 cents a minute ago, so...
I know. I'm gonna go out on Monday and buy the top of a microphone to replace this one, but it's gonna be blue.
And tiny, like Bob Barker's?
Yeah.
What was that style of microphone? Why was he the only one to ever have it?
Maybe that was his trademark.
Was that just it?
Like maybe if you go to the music store, you can ask for a Bob Barker mic, and they just know what you're talking about.
Well, you would know. So when you
how crap do I know?
When you become a broadcast, because you're wearing the coat, well, so you're a broadcaster and a professional at that. So is it like Harry Potter, where you have to go and get your wand, and so you go and get your microphone, you go to some shop with Mr. Ollivander, the professor, and it's, yeah, and it's like, ooh, tall.
Back to you, Steve.
Thin and skinny with a tiny little boob. That's perfect for you, Bob Barker. And Kirby, you get short, stout, and a little
bit... Well, everybody's excited down here. There's a big game on Sunday.
A little leany.
Every time I get bored, I'm gonna cut it back to the studio. At some point, we'll figure out where the studio is.
All right. Well, you may have noticed we also have...
Yeah, we'll come back to this.
Thank you. Okay. we also have the Wheel of Destiny stage. Now, we introduced the wheel a number of weeks ago, and it's just been a international hit.
International.
International. Whoa, hey, welcome.
No, we're closing the borders.
Uh-oh. Where have you been this whole time?
Sorry, let me just wipe this. Let me just wipe that. Yeah, right there.
Man. Well, I am patient zero.
You're already drinking beer. Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
look, I'm the mayor.
You know what? I'm just going to leave that there.
If anybody wants to play, they can give us... Is the number up? Oh, yeah, the number's up. So get... Oh, I should probably make sure my phone's not on silent. That happens.
Make sure it's not on silent?
Make sure it's not on silent. So people
because that's what we tell ourselves to go to sleep at night. Oh, it was on silent.
Oh, the whole
there
time.
There was thousands of folks probably called.
They wanted to.
We just didn't hear.
They wanted to. It was technical difficulties.
Yeah.
Exactly, Waba. Sports news, sports guy. Thank you. Hey, welcome, Econadilla, to the chat. Hello.
Hi.
Am I asking you the questions?
Well, no. I'm the sportscaster.
Yeah, you are.
Yeah.
All right. And so what is your prediction for Sunday's game?
Well, like I said, Jeff, it's going to be a big game. Everyone's excited. I'm just going to repeat that over and over again because I don't really... Like, who's playing?
Red.
Red.
It's red versus red.
Which shade of red?
It's a battle of red. Cardinal red. That's why we left the China lanterns up from last year's Lunar New Year celebration. Well done. That was the wave. it's red versus red in a battle of red to the dead. That's the slogan or something. You can buy a shirt. TeePublic. Okay, the shark's going to come back. That thing is just dripping oil.
Well, yeah.
Bob.
How do you think we pay for things around here? How do you think we keep the lights on?
I agree.
For just 10 cents to the show, you can feed a homeless angry puppet.
You're homeless?
Well,
you are
look
angry.
Around here, tell me.
No. I think it's a lovely home.
Make me pretty sleep behind the bar.
Pretty sweet
pad,
if I have to say so.
Yeah, I think so. We have China lanterns.
Yeah, you make me sleep in that cabinet above the bar back there.
More.
You chose that.
Yeah, that was like you ran down
here.
Yeah, I know.
Anybody that's seen Schlocky Seconds knows that's the best room in the house, baby.
Yeah. And when are we going to see more Schlocky Seconds?
Eventually.
Okay.
Yeah. It's being retooled. The network has pulled it for the time being. And it's being retooled.
Oh, yeah? The network pulled it?
It was controversial in so many ways. Ah, thank you, Waba.
Thank you, buddy.
Waba has cheered us for 10 bits, and he's doing his part to feed a homeless puppet.
Yeah.
You are. I salute
gonna
you,
me,
sir.
That's going to give me a six-pack.
Ooh, 10 bits.
Yeah.
Where do you get your alcohol? Or a six-pack of what, dog food?
It's at the. He gets it at the
I didn't
family,
say
family
a six-pack of
store.
What? I'm just saying a six-pack.
Of corn?
Maybe.
Creamed corn. That's about what you could get. Maybe. There's got to be
Kirkland
brand.
Creamed corn. We're going back to Costco, baby.
Yep, Costco. We gotta make Kirkland around everybody. Look,
we're going back to Costco.
I need a belt, vodka, and some gummy bears. All right. Now
you
I need
me with the toupee.
There's only. I didn't know
just
if that. Take was, it off. I didn't know if that was on purpose or
go.
Not.
No.
I was like, would that a gag?
It didn't work.
I ain't going to stop
there's
him.
There's pins in it.
Now, first got to remove a toupee to have more hair underneath.
Even more. Oh, there's a pin.
Put some in your beer.
Nobody wore
them. Oh, that's lovely.
Nobody
see,
wore
that's how the beer virus spreads, dude.
Ew, you just shook your fleas into my in your coronavirus.
Folks shaking their dandruff and other folks' beers. That's how it spread. Are we
Fox?
Are we Fox?
Yeah. Are we Fox News?
Spreading conspiracies?
No, I'm spreading truth.
We could be.
Back to you, Ship.
He's fired. The voice of reason. He's gone forever. But I agree. Sure. I think we are a lot like Fox News, spreading information, not misinformation. Yeah. Or maybe a little bit.
Maybe a little less dandruff and a little less beer, and maybe half the planet doesn't get snapped. I'm just saying. Thank you, Shia. Shia's woke. Shia knows what's woke. Up.
I'm surprised they don't just have an applause effect now in those talking head cable shows. Like, oh, yeah, you said something the corporate overlords agree with.
Yeah. Thank God that dude didn't get nominated for an Oscar. Can you imagine if Shia freaking LaBeouf gets nominated for an Oscar right now?
Right now?
I mean,
for Peanut Butter Falcon?
It's like, yeah, Trump's president. Might as well give Shia LaBeouf a freaking Oscar.
That's what America needs.
Yeah.
Shia LaBeouf to win an Oscar.
Yeah.
He's long overdue for some recognition.
I'll tell you one thing. That thing will never tarnish. You want to know why? That Oscar?
Well, oh, why?
Because he always LaBeouf it.
Oh!
Hey-o!
Oh, man. With jokes like that in the kind of door.
Mm-hmm. studio audience is
no studio audience. Actually does not support that applause.
Studio audience, the voice of reason.
Always and forever.
Well, Shia liked it.
Shia does. Shia likes a lot. He's it's a low bar.
We really established his taste.
Entertain Shia. Well, hey, welcome back.
Thank you.
You got rid of the blazer.
Yeah, and the mask.
Back to Kirby.
If I'm going to be patient zero, I might as well just get used to it.
No, you're already infected.
Yeah.
It's over.
I am.
You have 48 hours.
It started
hours.
Here, baby. I am the monkey.
You are the...
Monkey Dustin Hoffman is trying to catch.
Well, maybe people didn't miss... They caught the reference earlier or not, but you took a 23andMe DNA test this week.
Did
right?
I?
And remember, it identified your species.
Finally. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That's right.
That was the big news of the week.
I'm
in
a
the
surf
house.
Squatch.
So you are officially...
A surf squatch.
Surf squatch.
Yeah.
And that is not an arboreal type species.
I'm a surf squatch American.
Yeah. So it's Sasquatch, but on the beach. All right. So it's a beach dwelling.
Yeah.
You were born on the beach.
Yeah.
Who knew?
Yeah.
I mean.
Conceived under a lifeguard tower and born on the beach.
And born on the beach, baby.
Probably the same lifeguard tower.
I guarantee you. Yeah. Yeah. That's how your species.
My parents were pretty lazy. They didn't move very far.
No. Nor should they.
Yeah.
You find a lifeguard tower that works for you and get it on.
Yeah.
Hashtag origin stories.
Find the
stories.
Right one in Huntington Beach, and you're just, you know, within walking distance of Ruby's on the pier, and you got milkshakes and burgers whenever you want.
That's how you grew up.
Yeah.
It was a charmed life.
Yep.
Tell ya. And now I can enjoy your toupee as a pet.
Yeah.
It's a lovely...
What are we going to call it?
A lovely little guy. Well...
I think we should call it Marv.
I like Marv.
In honor of its daddy. Its daddy.
Oh, Albert, yeah. The backbiter.
Marv.
What did he get in trouble for? Didn't he bite somebody?
He wore underwear or something.
He did something. We won't go down that rabbit hole.
Yeah, no, let's kind of go there.
All right, let's leave Marv Albert in a good place.
Yeah.
Hi.
Well
esteemed.
Hopefully.
Yes. Yeah. I'm just going to stop altogether with the Marv. Because I guarantee you, it's worse than I think. It's worse than I remember.
Yeah, more than likely.
Yeah. Oh, I logged out again. Oh, God. Oh, no. Now you got it.
Hey, guys. What happens if your eye falls off?
Oh, no.
Well, that does
happen. Is that bad?
Oh, no.
Is that bad?
Oh, it did.
Is that bad?
It did.
Is that bad?
Are you sure it's not rolled back in your head? It's really gone. It's gone.
Is that bad?
Oh, it's gone.
Yeah, it's gone, dude.
No, it's nothing. It's like just...
I have zero depth.
Don't touch it. It's going to spread.
I think I got it. I think I'm...
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Your hand's going to fall off. Your hand's going to fall off.
Quick! Well, don't worry. I'm sure somebody out there will come up with a quick antidote for this terrible virus that's spreading
if we're lucky.
Within the basement all of a sudden. I don't know if coronavirus symptoms include
beer virus
retina detachment, but
yeah, I think that's one of the symptoms.
It is.
Yeah.
Maybe a new one.
Yeah.
All right. Well, we got to lock down the basement then.
Yeah, all right. Do.
Nobody in, quarantine. Nobody out. Nobody in, nobody out.
Yeah.
Nobody in, nobody
that's
out.
That's how they interrogate victims.
All right. So if we... Oops, God. So if we do...
Let's quarantine this place.
All right. If we have to be stuck inside while we either die from this virus or
we will survive.
Somebody needs the cards.
Or spread it far and wide.
Aretha Franklin said so.
The cards are over there.
Who? Aretha Franklin?
Didn't she?
What'd she say?
Somebody said we would survive.
Gladys Knight?
Gloria. That's it.
No.
Nope, that's not it.
Gloria Gaynor.
Gloria Gaynor?
That's it.
I thought that was a...
You better be freaking right.
That was an Olympic athlete, I thought.
Somebody with a beautiful voice said we would survive, and I believed them.
Tony
I believed him, Jeff. I believed
him. Tony Clifton. That's how you do the CPR. No, that's Staying Alive by the Bee Gees.
Wow.
Yeah, never mind.
That's where I was. Yeah. Okay.
Is that what you're? No, you were singing "I Will Survive" by Gaynor's right. Enron.
Gaynor.
Hey, thanks, Enron. I knew we could count on you.
WorldCom.
Enron World. Enron _ WorldCom. They're two different entities. All right.
Yeah. So glad I still have one eye left to read your glorious name.
Oh man, the corporate overlords are watching us now.
Yeah, they are. Here we go.
It's Gladys Knight too, but who sung the song?
Eventually, it ought to be a
what?
Toys R Us full of stuffed Kirby's on the shelf next to the McConadillas that are also stuffed with the postering on the back.
What, you guys are going to market yourselves?
Yeah.
As stuffies?
The corporate overlords are going to pick us up. They're going to put us on TV.
Nah.
You know.
I don't like pizza. I don't like heights.
Chance, welcome to the chat room. Oh, he's got a thesis. Every time I hear about these viruses, I think of a prog rock song on assignment, and then later.
So many words.
Probably about H1N1.
Many words. And thanks for the dinner party story, buddy.
Sir, that's didn't start and go anywhere. Oh, no. And, oh, I see. It's so long it got cut off, and the computer was like, I can't compute. Can't compute Chance Danger. Well, hey, welcome, buddy. Hope you're having a fine Stupor Bowl Eve.
Stupor Bowl weekend.
Yes.
Stupor Bowl Eve.
So far we have, Oka's going for.
XIIVI.
Going for KC. KCK, Casey Moe,
Casey
I don't know.
Casey Kasem.
Somebody please tell me where the stadium is located. And I'm going for the Buffalo Bills.
Oh, yeah. Where's the game being played this year?
Miami. Yes. And Miami, I think there's been 17 different Super Bowls that took place in Miami.
Wow.
Over the years. This is Super Bowl.
And how many stabbings?
54. There's been 135 stabbings. Yeah.
How many stabbings at Miami Super Bowl games?
Yes, 135.
Yeah. Speaking of stabbings.
On field.
Per game.
Yeah, this isn't like
per game per
stabbings.
Stand. Yeah.
Per quarter.
Yeah,
yes.
Per quarter.
There's 135 per quarter, so times
it's
four
a rough
quarters.
Town. It's a rough town. I've
did
been
y'all there. See that alligator in the news?
Which
with
one?
Knife sticking out its head?
Oh, what?
That guy.
Somebody stuck a knife in an alligator.
Somebody
head.
Stabbed an alligator, and that sucker just kept swimming.
It was fine?
Yeah.
So it was alive.
I think it's mayor of Florida now.
More than likely.
Hey,
they like voted
mayor
in Jacksonville.
I would vote for an alligator that survived a head stab.
Yeah.
My goodness. I mean, what else is possible for this alligator?
I mean, if a knife can't take him down.
Shit. He may have improved things. Maybe
maybe he's the solution to beer virus.
There's only one way to find out. To Florida!
To Florida! We fly!
Oh, wow, that was a long flight, guys. Woo.
Y'all ever had a fever dream? Because that's what this is.
Welcome to Florida, everybody.
McConadilla.
Why am I talking like
guess
that?
Guess what?
What's up?
I just realized. Tomorrow we get to flip over the calendar.
We what?
Yeah, the WWF calendar. We get to flip it over
to
February.
Yeah, February. That's oh, my
right.
God.
Yeah.
What would it
tomorrow
be?
It's February.
Who knows?
Yeah. Next week it'll be all new.
Yeah.
From 1992.
Wow. So get ready for that.
Yeah, too. All new from 1992.
Yeah, if you don't know, 2020 and 1992 are like mirror image years of each other. So if you have a calendar from 1992 laying around, which you do.
It's over Jeff's shoulder there.
Yeah, it's back there.
Have we set up a close-up yet?
Not yet.
Yeah, we forgot to do it.
I forget who's on there, too. It's some brothers who wear
pink. It's somebody
blue.
Awesome.
Yeah.
It's spandex. And it's
blue spandex.
Very
somebody in
spandex brothers.
It's the spandex brothers.
If anybody can look up who was the calendar image of the January 1992 WWF calendar.
Yeah, let us know.
Yeah, let us know.
Do some Googling out
there. Yeah. Hey, Chance Danger, why don't you write us a dissertation on whoever the heck's on that calendar, huh? Yeah.
Figure it out. We need biography and family history. Current home address, if they are still alive. If deceased, location of cemetery, so we can pay tribute in other ways.
We should bet on who's going to get us the answer to this first.
I'm going to bet Okus.
Yeah. My money's on you. Two to one.
Enron, though. Enron.
2-1. Enron coming in hard.
Enron is out there, and he's active.
Yep.
All right.
Oh, Royal Rumble.
Royal Rumble. Oh! Oh, you're right. Royal Rumble is the event that's on January 1992 calendar.
Oh, that's great.
I don't know. Maybe those are the guys that won that Royal Rumble.
I got my side back.
Welcome back. Oh, look at you're already healing.
Ah, you're in three dimensions.
It is Donny Marie Osmond.
We just needed to talk about wrestling.
We did.
It actually looks a lot like them.
It does.
It's very
eerily
similar.
In order to get my eye back, I had to convert to Judaism.
Well, that's a powerful, actually, sort of.
Hey, it means I have eternal, something, salvation or something, I'm
Judaism
sure.
Judaism returns sight.
I mean, I'm counting on that. That's what I paid for.
No. Yeah. You paid something?
Membership.
How it works.
It's like Scientology. You know, I got to sign.
No.
Oh, man, the guy I met charged me. Shoot.
Where'd you meet him?
Dang it. Hollywood Walk of Fame. is that not right?
Well, it depends.
Shoot. And yeah. I bought a little Oscar statue from him, too.
Okay. Well, that's probably legit.
Yeah, okay, that one's legit. All right, it's probably a real statue.
You have been sweeping up awards.
Yeah, I'll get LaBeouf to LaBeouf it, and I'll sell it or something.
Which he would do.
He's selling that one hard.
He would do for a pretty... Rockers are the... they're the Rockers. Enron. Bum, bum, bum. In the tale of McConaughey.
Hey, he just won $10.
Hey, Boris, welcome. Yeah,
hey,
Enron.
Baby, how's it going?
Enron.
How's it going, my man?
We're good people, my friend.
Enron, he's like, I wasn't even alive in
1992. Oh!
No.
Who
that's
was?
Why you're
who
the
was?
Best at Googling.
Yeah,
who was?
I don't know.
What a
you
weird.
Tell me.
1992. Tanya Harding was at the top of the game. The international world of
and
ice
young
skating.
Jim Carrey was on the In Living Color.
And he was making America laugh with his rubber expressions.
And America was 1 year away from the start of The Simpsons.
1992.
LA riots
were either happening or just had finished.
I have a commemorative trash can from that.
Yeah, we were smoldering.
It's a collector's piece. It was only made of a thousand of them.
You have a garbage can
commemorating the LA riots.
What is on it? Just
it just says, "Can't we all just get along?" All
right.
Here, trash can was used in LA riots. Went through window.
Oh my God, that's amazing! Does it have autographs?
I have number 392 of 1,000.
Of 1,000, that's a collector's item, my friend.
That's a good one.
That's good. Now I know.
Yeah, Simpsons was 89. You are right.
Yes.
You're right.
It had been
on 3 years of Simpsons by then.
It was hitting a good stride by that point, though. Yeah.
They already. Know what else happened today?
They already pissed off the first lady.
What happened?
What?
In 1992. Today's the day that that chick ripped up the picture of the Pope on SNL.
That's right.
Oh, that's for you, Sinead. Boris. That's for you, babe.
Sinead O'Connor.
Sinead.
Show us making a point.
Yeah.
It was widely misunderstood.
But yeah, good. That's what it was.
It was good. You know.
No, but today we can look back and say, yeah, she was kind of right. But hey, we don't need
to. Well, who knows? That's the right hook. Who knows?
Yeah, stir up who that knows? Stew.
Sorry, are you ancient religious weirdos?
Ancient?
I mean, people.
Catholics.
Catholics? That's what I meant.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Either one. Yeah, no, that was a lot of controversy.
I have no problem with people that believe in Santa Claus and stuff. I have no problem with adults who believe in Santa Claus.
Tumultuous.
No problem at all.
Oh, boy.
That's a bumper sticker.
Wow, this show's getting serious.
Is that a segue into, like, because we did get our
Where's the orange guy with the sports suit again? Let's get him out here to really interview people.
Boris, we did get our first sponsor this week.
Oh, who do we get?
Yeah.
Oh, who do we get?
We did. So I don't
Cut
know if this
in.
Is an
We're gonna be rich.
An appropriate segue, but
Cut
we,
me in.
It is time to present.
All
so
right, you do that, I'm going to go get a beer.
So welcome. Well, hold on. You got to watch the...
This is a big moment.
All right, so it's the Stupor Bowl, and we had an advertiser approach us saying, hey, guys, it's Stupor Bowl. We can't quite afford a Super Bowl ad, but we would love to advertise on the Stupor Bowl. And we said, well, okay, we'll see if
how
we
How much are they paying us?
Room into the program. We don't know that. We'll find out later, I think.
Yeah, but it's in bits, so.
It's all in bits.
Don't get excited.
Yeah, so, all right, anyway.
This isn't going to go well.
Anyway, our first and only sponsor is Jar of Pickle.
Ooh.
Yes. Jar of Pickle is, of course, America's favorite brand of pickle.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Exactly. So, I haven't seen this yet. This is a brand new world premiere, everybody, of...
Freaking heck.
...of the Jar of Pickle commercial. So, they wanted us to show it. I'm gonna show it now.
Yeah.
All right.
Sauerländer Gordon, Knackig, and this.
I want to know what that chick says.
What?
We need to Google translate that.
Wow.
What the crap was that?
Hey, that was a great commercial. Wow. Jar of pickle.
I wish I could clap. Wow. I don't know how to clap.
I'm going home. I don't even know what to say about that.
In All Night Live.
Pure awesome is what that was.
Sponsored by Jar of Pickle. Jar of Pickle, where cucumbers go to die.
Good job with the cue card.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. So, hey, I'm excited about our first sponsor. I think we're really making some strides in the world. Anyway, is our mic back on? Yeah, okay.
I hope so. Oh, there's a weird mouth song playing again.
Oh, no. I hope not.
No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. Okay. You're all sensitive. You're like, you took me serious.
Sometimes I don't know. People have to let me know. Hey, so, anyway, do you guys want to play some wheel games? Let's see what a topic would be. All right, if we just spin the wheel. All right, let's take a gander at what the Wheel of Destiny has to offer. All right, what's that topic?
Geography.
Yeah, I know. I'm like, ugh. I gotta memorize what the color.
Well, the cards are way over on the other side of the room.
Well, geography. That's an
geography.
Interesting topic.
I know the shit out of geography.
Things I learned about geography this week. Miami, the city that's hosting the Super Bowl, is sinking. That's right, everybody. It's sinking while the tides are rising.
I hope that alligator with the knife in his head is going to be okay.
He will find a home.
I hope so.
He will actually be the best of all, I think.
You have a home here.
Habitat-wise.
If your home floods, buddy.
Yeah. I mean, we'll
take you in. Sorry.
You really have a soft spot for this.
I don't know. Do you really want to live with somebody from Florida?
I'm impressed.
Alligator in the head.
Do you really want to live with somebody from Florida?
Even an alligator with a knife in his head?
No, thank you, sir.
What do you got against Florida? Just the weirdest things
happening.
Florida. Hey, I like Florida. Anyway, that's what I learned about geography this week. Kirby, what did you learn about
Florida.
Geography this week?
That's what we learned. Florida. Florida is weird. Freaking weird.
Florida's freaking weird? That's what you learned?
Yeah. Trivia of the week.
Jesus, where'd you learn? You're not, you know, the people come to get knowledge. They come to grow as people.
Hey, there's no light bulb in the corner of the screen. This isn't an illuminating piece of television.
You what? You need something going bing?
Wheel in the sky.
That was a dud. Nobody knows nothing about nothing. All right, history.
History.
God.
What do you want to know? Ask me anything.
Let's see. Ask me anything about history? Okay. All right. What was the what was on top of the pyramids originally? Like when they were brand new?
Oh, this is a good one.
Yeah.
This is a good one. And I have to tell you, it's been a very long time since I've had the time to discuss this with somebody. Because, you know, it's one of my favorite topics.
I know it is. That's
it's one of my favorite topics. And if you can't tell, I'm stalling for time.
No shit.
I can't come up with something. And I'm trying to think, but I really can't. I'm going to say a guy playing a trumpet.
That's very close. Old world pigeon.
He didn't say fantasies.
You know how I feel about pigeons.
But no, I'm sorry, Chance.
If you're out there.
It was an old
Penelope. If you're out there. You know where I am.
Oh,
call me.
A Tinder date? Another Tinder date gone awry?
Yeah, we know how Ace and Pisa went.
Yeah, no. They're murderers. If everybody missed that, we're going to have to do another murder mystery.
Yeah, if only we had a clip.
Exactly. that's it. Let me push the button. Let me push the clip button.
Let's see if it works.
Let's see let's give it a shot.
All right, I got a green thing. Did it make a clip? So I've been trying to program the Stream Deck to make a clip, right? Because we need clips. So I hit the clip a button, but I don't know if it works. So somebody out there, go check our clip profile or whatever.
Spin the wheel.
Wherever these things go. All right. Are we done with history?
Yeah, I think so.
We learned a lot.
We learned a valuable lesson. Entertainment.
Hey, well.
On the biggest weekend. Oh, no, that's next weekend.
That's next weekend.
Next weekend.
And I was driving.
Where you're going to be live from your room on Friday next week.
Oh, yeah. Yes. Yeah, so next Friday will be a little different, right?
Yeah, I got a date.
Kirby's got a date.
Hot date.
McConadilla's got grubs. The hub. He's going to... Bless you.
Well, bless you, buddy.
Kazoom tight. So it might be a puppet-free show.
Yeah.
A fabricated free show. yeah. next week. I'll still be here.
Hijinks will still ensue, we promise.
I have nothing going on.
I don't know. Maybe we'll figure it out. We'll know.
Maybe we'll figure it out.
Yeah, we'll figure it out.
Jesus. Christmas crunch.
Beer virus.
He's back.
Beer virus.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. Right in your beer. Appreciate Sip that it. Up. Drink it.
I hit the button.
Smell it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So ask me an entertainment question.
Oh, yeah. All right. Entertainment. Who is going to be the Super Bowl halftime show performer this year? It's a future
trivia question. The Jonas Brothers.
I'm sorry. That's incorrect.
No, that's the future. It'll be the Jonas Sisters after they've transitioned.
And it's actually...
Jay-Z and Beyonce.
Ihr lieben Menschenkinder, nun hört mal her. Ihr macht den kleinen Fichten das Leben schwer.
I don't know. I think we're in for a
treat.
Man,
that video is creepier and creepier every time we play it.
Yes, indeed. Well, if you want to, I don't know, if you want to play trivia, we did have football trivia. We thought about.
We did. Bring it up on the thingy.
See if I have a thingy. Oh, Super Bowl 54 fun facts. And
fun facts.
They weren't actually very fun.
There were trivia on there, though.
All right, football trivia.
That's okay. We don't, man.
It's a sports, on the wheel?
We can just get the cards over there.
What?
We can just go get the cards over there.
Oh, yeah. You want to grab those?
Yeah. We kind of do. Will you grab the cards over there, the Trivial Pursuit cards?
Which category?
All of them.
All of them.
Hand them to Jeff so he can pull them.
All right. So if you guys want to play, somebody call. And
I'm help.
We have some merch to give away, of course. If you get all six questions right, we'll send you a mug.
All right.
Exactly.
Big money, babe.
Fun.
Big money, babe.
Oh, wait. The number's not up. So... Anyway, you got to call that number.
I see the number.
If somebody calls, we'll jump over. If not, whatever. We don't have to.
Hey, you're the boss, man.
Or you guys want to play.
You're the only human here. You're in charge.
Right, well, in that case, I'm going to play your pick.
In that case, I'm going to eat all these Girl Scout cookies.
Oh, yeah, and we got Girl Scout cookies.
Hey-o!
Tis the season. They're pretty good. These are tag-alongs.
Tag-alongs.
Yes.
Tag-along, little doggy. Tag-along, little doggy.
A lot better. I wish this was our sponsor, not damn pickle jar.
I know. Screw pickles. Hey, I'm so sorry. Sponsor. I didn't mean that.
Don't worry. They only sponsored the first half of the show.
So tight.
Don't worry. They're not our sponsors anymore. They dropped us.
Did they? Ah. Yeah. At least we got that one paycheck.
No, they only paid for the first 30 minutes.
Yeah.
And they were like, we're done.
Whatever. That was a creepy commercial anyway. It's kind of phallic, honestly, if I'm going to be honest...
Well, pickles in general, unfortunately, have that
ain't they?
Distinction about them, right? Along with bananas, eclairs, submarine sandwiches, you know, a whole fish, if you're just going to, like, eat a fish, duck style. Twinkies, of course. Hot dogs, naturally.
Of course.
I haven't spent any time thinking about phallic objects, but... Oh, no. Oh, shit.
Oh, he found the stash. He
found the stash. Oh, crap.
Son of a bitch.
Ladies and
that
gentlemen,
was for to.
This is not good.
Later.
This is not good. Kirby has.
He's overdosing.
A box of tagalongs.
Have you ever seen a Ghost Scout cookie overdose? It's ugly.
It's not
it's
good.
It's ugly.
He shakes like this. This is going to go on for about 3 hours.
Hey, get the marker.
Hey.
What did we do last
time? Are we
going
to play
a adrenaline shot in the heart. I saw Pulp Fiction. That's what we do.
All right, maybe Trivia will comment that. Yeah, we need an EpiPen to the heart.
Yep.
I'm assuming.
We need Patricia Arquette with all that shit in her face. Yeah.
Yes, where's my bathrobe and heroin?
Yeah.
All right. Oh, God, he crashed.
Ah, too late.
Do you need insulin?
At
don't know.
At least he died well.
Does he need more sugar now or less?
Good question.
Yeah, because he's had a lot.
I think you need to perform mouth-to-mouth on Kirby right now. Mm-hmm. Right now. We need Kirby's corpse up here for you to perform mouth-to-mouth on.
Look, give me some.
You need to revive him, Jeff.
He's back. All right, buddy. All right,
Brody,
buddy.
He's going to go. He's going to flatline. thank God. Come on, breathe. Breathe, you bastard. Live. Live.
Wow.
Thank God. Not another death on
the
show.
Oh, my God.
You had a Caesar salad for dinner.
You said it. Not another death. We can't afford another one.
How many? No, we've had three. That's,
yeah.
I call it at three. If Kirby died, I was canceling the show.
Freaking heck.
It tastes like dragon brandy.
You know.
Oh, yeah? Really? That's funny.
Dragon brandy.
Dragon brandy. Next sponsor.
Next sponsor, please. Costco presents. EpiPens are expensive. I don't know. If it came down to EpiPens or you, Kirby.
Tough choice.
Tough choice. Man.
I mean, like, we could save his life, or we could sell this sweet EpiPen for a nice profit.
That's it.
And I mean, his worth, the worth. It's tricky.
These are the decisions and choices we have to weigh each and every day.
Yeah. Oh, there's a rat walking by. Scoot, rat, scoot.
Cheese. Scoot. Is it the long lost cheese, my best friend in the whole world? He went away. Yeah, well, cheese was fun. He did now.
You were so nice to save his life.
I did.
He totally could have died.
He did die.
And
eventually.
We could have, I mean, who knows what money we could have got for his corpse.
Well, if I remember correctly, you're the one who ate him. My pet mouse.
I think that's why I felt bad.
Yeah, you felt a tinge.
I felt like
you.
We should save this one.
Yeah.
I usually eat him.
No, this is why I'm just stroking the toupee now.
Yeah.
This is the only pet that will stay with me forever.
Son of a gun.
Oh, all the others run away or be eaten by my roommates.
This whole world is higher than it normally is. Dang it.
Are we a little higher than
usual? I think so.
Are you struggling there?
I'm struggling here. My dogs are barking.
I hear you, brother.
That's what that is.
I hear you, brother.
It's all right, bro.
All right.
It's all right. We saved a laugh.
We did.
You've got beer virus. Laugh is good. Well, sort of.
Well, we have 48 to 72 hours, I think, before it.
Yeah, before you die or?
That's it.
Yeah. But you're quarantined now.
So I'm sealed in. Well, look, I rarely leave anyway, so I was pretty much like, I don't even know. I think it was the mailman. I had one interaction this week, and it was with the mailman, and he was coming from Hershey, Pennsylvania.
Ooh, yeah.
Just returning.
That's a bad place.
From his.
Yeah, you don't want to be caught there at night.
There's
stabbings. Oh, I was thinking of a different place.
No, you're right. There's stabbings, but there's also in Miami. That's where the stabbing thing came from. But gotcha. Hershey, Pennsylvania is no friendly burg. But it's the hammer is their choice in Hershey.
Ooh.
The Hershey hammer guys. And so the Hershey hammer guys walk around and you're like, I don't know. Are they going to sell me chocolate bars? No, hammer. Hammer to the noggin.
Just a bunch of out of work Oompa Loompas and shit?
Yes, exactly. Exactly. They were shipped in the 80s.
Very different here on the West Coast.
During the chocolate boom.
That means something very different here on the West Coast.
The Hershey Hammer boys? What other meaning could that be? You know, I thought it was very clear
if
that
if you
it's...
need to know more, search my Tinder profile to find out.
You did have that embroidered on your blazer, didn't you?
We're going to have McConadilla and I are working on Tinder accounts. It's going to be part of our big Valentine's Day epic spectacular.
You're both working on your own, like together?
We're working on the Valentine's Day show.
So explain this. You guys are working on Tinder profiles.
We're not together.
In tandem?
No. No, we're each making a Tinder profile.
Are you going to be in competition? Like who gets the most
Who gets
likes?
The most swipey swipes?
Swipey swipes?
Swipey snipes.
Does it have to go
snippy
further?
Swipes.
Swipey swipes?
Who gets the most snipey swipes?
Snippy snipes?
Snipey swipes.
Spiffy swipey snipes.
Snipey swipes.
Join spiffysnipeyswipes.com. The only dating app you need. Proud sponsor of In All Night Live.
Snippy Snappy Snips.
Brought to you by Pickles.
Jar of Pickles.
Jar of Pickle. It's just one. It's not even plural. I don't know. So I think you might only get one pickle in the jar, but I'm hoping it was lost in translation because it was obviously
maybe
a foreign company. I wasn't aware.
I don't know.
Hopefully.
It was just a German pickle.
Was it German? Or was it, I think
it was German.
No idea what language that was.
I don't know. Who else is going to buy pickles?
Look, I just signed the contract.
Americans and Germans. Who else buys pickles? Maybe the French.
That's a good question.
Maybe the French.
Where are
the French. The French, they like a pickle.
What's the origin of pickles? We need to figure that out, all right? Where did they come from? Who was
everybody,
the first?
Pickling goes back, you know.
Oh, I suppose.
It's a long time.
Pickling in general.
Yeah.
What do you do with a cucumber?
See?
Put it in
the
vinegar.
The show is educational.
What
would happen if we pickled Kirby?
Ugh.
What?
I got pretty close last weekend.
Actually, you're doing a pretty good job yourself.
Was it last
weekend? Yeah, I was going to say.
Oh, no, it was the weekend before when we were at watching the UFC fight.
Self-pickled.
Yeah. Oh, man, I got pickled.
Yeah.
I got pickled. You put me by the shore, man, and I get pickled.
Oh, we have so many pickles. All right, Enron, I knew it. I was like, please, Enron. More googly. Pixel's been around for thousands of years. Are you kidding?
Okay, he's
Enron
putting,
is on
he's
it.
He's putting Craig out of a job.
Wow. All right, cucumbers.
He's putting Craig out of a job, this Enron guy.
Yeah, yeah, no.
Yeah. Craig, you're hired, dude.
Yeah.
We can't pay you much, but you're around.
Craig's our science and technical advisor, and he did not show up at all.
No, he hasn't been showing up lately.
No,
you got to dock that kid's pay.
All right, so pickles have been around for thousands of years, dating as far back as 2030 BC. Wow.
Oh.
When cucumbers from their native India were pickled in the Tigris Valley, one of the cradles of civilization.
You don't say.
Yeah, so the word pickle comes from the Dutch pickle, or Northern German pickel,
okay,
meaning salt or brine. Makes sense. Which are also, of course, two very important components in the pickling process. Enron, WorldCom.
The more you know.
The more you know.
I just love it when you talk all smart.
Good for you, Enron.
Yeah, see? Shia likes the brine.
That was for you, buddy.
Shia is Hebrew for brine.
Thanks, Enron. I knew Enron would turn around and do something good.
Dude, that's the third save, Enron. You saved the combo. Yeah,
you got a lot to make up for, but you're on your way.
Yeah, you know this. Email us your info and we'll send you something.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. And we do.
Yeah, so like all kinds of fraudulent ideas.
You may get a pamphlet of unethical life projects.
Oh, we've got pyramid schemes out the ass.
Yeah.
You'd love it.
Amway.
So,
yeah.
Email us nlnightlive@gmail.com to subscribe to our newsletter.
Oh, do you think they're going to want to buy some candles from me?
Well, they will not have a choice.
Yeah.
Because who could pass
up? Oh, you're going to get the best candles?
The deals that you offer.
I'll save you the good ones, not the ones that smell like a foot.
No, those are a niche
audience. No. We sell those to only certain people.
But surprisingly, they are swift. They really fly off the shelf, the feet candles. Yes. We don't ask questions.
Yeah, Shredder always comes by and buys them all. I don't know why.
Shredder.
Give me a LeBuff.
All right, any reference to the foot, and you're tying it together with our sponsor, who apparently has a tie-in with Ninja Turtles in a dirty, dirty way.
Yeah, dirty, dirty.
Yeah.
Kirby's goop candles, baby.
Yeah, we did have the goop candle conversation last week.
You did paddle dust a couple bucks.
Really? Oh, thank you, Enron.
Thank you so much.
Did he really?
Yeah, we're going to send you some stuff, man.
Enron, we're going to hook you up. Thank you so much.
Appreciate it.
My God, that's amazing. Thank you. Well, we enjoy streaming.
And I think Ohokus deserves, some stickers and
stuff. I agree.
You gotta send us your info, dude.
And I'm gonna go
send you a couple stickers and some whatnot.
Yes. So nlnightlive@gmail.com. Send us, anonymous sort of, but safe shipping information.
Hey,
we're very trustworthy.
Can you have Kirby package this stuff?
Embezzling.
I'm gonna package it up.
Sorry.
Let's not give him the beer virus and have him. shoot! Now you have beer virus. We're gonna have somebody that ain't got beer virus package it for you.
Yeah. we got it twice.
The money, I do love a laundered buck. I'm telling you.
Man, crisp, clean, illegal.
Nice and laundered.
Hey, we got a call coming in.
Nice and laundered.
ladies and germs, welcome to In All Night Live.
Oh, hey, hello.
Hi.
Well, hi. Who do we have on the phone tonight?
Oh, hey, this is Scott Norwood.
Oh, ooh. Now, if everyone doesn't know who Scott Norwood is.
Who is Scott Norwood?
Sorry, Scott.
Introduce give us a rundown.
All right, Scott, what's your bio? Tell us your shame.
Well, this weekend traditionally isn't very lucky for me. So I was hoping maybe I could spin the wheel of destiny and maybe redeem myself a little bit.
All right. I think Scott Norwood deserves a chance.
Answer a trivia question.
At redemption. So if you don't know, Scott Norwood is the one who fumbled the Buffalo Bills' first Super Bowl.
Oh, that guy.
Yeah, he missed the field goal.
Not just once.
No.
No
Ray Finkel.
He is exactly Ray Finkel.
You're no Ray Finkel.
I think the basis of that character is for sure must have been. But hey, you run a successful strip club in Buffalo now, so we're all about
that. Yeah. Does he have a breakfast buffet?
I believe he does.
That'd be pretty great.
And I believe it's
Legs and Eggs.
Legs and Eggs. I believe the bar is called Wide Left.
Don't steal my idea.
All right,
that's the question.
Okay, so we're here at the Wheel of Destiny. Well, welcome to the Wheel of Destiny! An In All Night Live game show spectacular! Sponsored by Jar of Pickle. All right, let's spin and see what you get. You can't be successful without a breakfast buffet.
Oh, it's a purple.
You need
purple
eggs
one
each and every day.
That's a purple one.
Get some bacon and
toast. McConaughey Hennis, the purple card.
Ah! A croissant for the road at the breakfast.
That's a good question.
At the breakfast buffet. Yeah. Well,
I think we've lost our host.
Sign.
Yeah. Well, he's gone, ladies and gentlemen.
It's a breakfast buffet song.
Okay, ask a question.
All right. Well, all right. What was the? What was the thing? Oh.
Hi.
Is that Miles?
It's Miles. Hey, Miles.
Hello.
All right. Miles, welcome to the show. I did get taken by the beer virus real quick.
Thank you.
Do you see yourself dancing in the background? Show you real quick. Oh, yeah. Sorry. You're not watching it. Yeah, you're dancing there in the background, buddy.
I'm the best.
You are the
I know that.
You are the best. Do you want to help? You want to help mommy answer a art and literature question? Ooh.
Scott Norwood, not mommy.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, yeah, it's Scott. Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Would you like to help Uncle Scott with his art and literature questions? All right.
Scott sounds very masculine and rough and tough.
Uncle Scott. All right. Okay. Here we go.
Ready for a question?
All right. The name of this person is the name.
The name of this person is the name.
In the year 2004... He became the first person to become a billionaire by writing books.
This is for Miles, right?
You make a billionaire book.
Yeah, who is the who became
Dr. Seuss.
Oh, that's a good guess.
That's a good guess.
That's a really good guess. I'm gonna say right. I think Dr. Seuss.
But
you got the plug.
Let go out there. Try again.
Does Scott have a guess?
What do you think, Scott? Bring it home, Scotty.
Clearly.
Bring it home, Scotty. What do you got?
What do you think, Scott? Who's the billionaire author? Who's the only author that could really be a billionaire?
Who's really the only?
Come on.
The Harry Potter lady.
Oh, yeah.
Don't even know the name. Scott is sexist.
The ball is heading left, buddy. It's getting there. It's not quite lost yet, but it's getting there.
Oh, God, I'm always so close.
Oh, it's gone. Oh, God, you blew it again. Scott, it was your chance at redemption. Oh, Scott, well, I'm sorry. You lose again. Yeah. No, at this game, at football, at life in general.
Damn.
I'm sorry, Scott.
Wow. I know. I'm a loser.
Back to you, Steve.
Well, try to get over your sorrows this weekend, Scott.
It's obviously George R. R. Martin.
I'll call you next year.
All right, give us a call next Super Bowl weekend. Maybe you'll get lucky.
Yes. Scott.
Bye, Miles.
Scott.
Scott. Hey, Scott.
Hey, Miles. Bye, Miles.
Bye, Miles. Bye, Miles.
Bye, Scott. Oh, Miles and Scott.
Did he not really get that?
That was funny. All right. Well done, JK. Yes, you always got it.
Yeah, there we go.
You know, I'm surprised as well that Stephen King is not a billionaire. He's had almost every book on the number one bestseller. I mean, it's on the cover.
And it's like every other freaking book is a movie.
Yeah, and every movie, yes, exactly, which he's a producer of.
Yeah.
Executive producer. So he gets a chunk of that change. Huh. That silver bullet money keeps coming in. He gets royalties for that every Halloween.
Oh, yeah. I mean, Corey Haim was clearly a billionaire.
Clearly.
I mean.
You know, and he still got to keep that sick wheelchair.
I saw him all over town riding around. Yeah. He would just cruise him down Hollywood Boulevard in that wheelchair. Yeah, fuck all y'all! You just hear that as he drives by.
Exactly. Yeah. He'd just flip everybody off. The original Segway, they called it.
Gary Busey's just like, that's my boy.
That's my boy. Oh, boy. Yeah, they used to act that out every Wednesday on the corner of Hollywood and Highland.
Yeah.
Oh. It'd just be, there's Gary.
I'm doing my Gary Busey right now. Watch.
Okay.
Astounding. Astounding.
Wow.
You know, if the Oscars weren't only a week away, I would nominate you.
If they weren't already. Unfortunately, the envelopes are sealed.
I think they are sealed. Yes. Otherwise, no. I'd make some calls. No, I'd make some calls, dude.
The voting goes through Tuesday. There's still time.
There's still time?
Yeah. Oh, is all right. There?
Well, clip it. I'll hit clip it. That'll work.
Yeah, yeah, Jeff, you make that clip. Live. We'll send it to the FYC. Academy.
Yes.
I'm making quotes.
FYC.
Academy. Yeah, yeah.
FYC.
We're totally sending that out, dude.
IANFYC.
It's en route. Success. All right, we're heading to the big time now, everybody.
Hashtag IANFSE.
.org.
Hashtag what the fuck?
Hashtag IANFCFYT.
Sure.
For your consideration.
For your consideration.
And on that live, for your consideration.
I got
it. It's award season, man. You got to work out the
it
hashtag.
It even took Beer Virus a second to figure that out.
Guys, you know what it's going to take to get to the Oscars this year?
Beer Virus.
I hope.
But it's going to take money. A whole lot of spending money. It's going to take plenty of money.
That's it.
Yep.
You're getting a lot of mileage out of that one.
I think that's what it's took for the last 88 Oscars or whatever it is, honestly.
Yeah.
Well, no, you know, to do it right.
Sure.
To do it right now. Yeah, well, I've had fun. You guys had fun?
Yeah. I'm all right.
How you guys doing?
I'm all right. Yeah. I mean, other than the beer virus.
I'm ready for more hot dogs.
You know.
More hot dogs? We were going to have a hot dog eating
contest. Oh, yeah. Weren't we going to make Jeff eat as many hot dogs as he could?
We were going to make him eat wings.
Yeah. But it almost became that. But no.
Our insurance wouldn't cover it.
Yeah, no.
Oh, he's playing the human card.
Yeah, see, I have a digestive tract.
The meat bag card. Yes.
He doesn't have innards made of felt, so he's playing the human card. Like, my innards are too sensitive. I can't eat 100 hot dogs.
I get inflamed. I have inflammation, okay? It's a human thing, all right? Things expand, they contract.
Yeah, apparently all this crap is made of, like, flesh or something in there.
Liquid.
It's the same thing as the rats I eat, because, like, they're kind of gummy.
I'm juicy.
Is that what's inside
chewy.
You?
Yeah, I'm juicy and chewy.
See, we're filled with delicious... wonderful felt. It's delicious. It's wonderful.
I have. That's what I sleep on each and every night. Yeah. My pillow.
Yeah, it's too bad you're filled with that bullshit. Whatever you're filled with.
Cookie Monster is the world champion eater.
He is the best.
I don't care what anybody says until he gets his due in the Guinness Book of World Records.
Cookie.
That dude needs his due.
Well, see, I can do.
Hi ho, it's Kermit the Frog here reporting.
What?
Reporting live from the pond.
I don't know what that sound is. Copyright!
Yeah. We're gonna go live
to
pee.
They're beeping us out right now.
Who's interviewing some chicken?
I think there's a SWAT team outside after that right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, mine is Dominic. All the way.
Well, we could do another spin of the wheel if you want.
Uh-huh.
You wanna do one more? Or are we good?
Yeah, I don't know.
Well, all right. Next week, I guess we could do some administrative tasks. All right. Email us at inonlylive@gmail.com. Follow us on Instagram, of course, where we have photos and everything. Dreadlord Disney is coming for you.
Look, oh, they're already here, baby.
It was established. Yeah, Disney already owns
me. They're coming for us.
Jess K told us last week that was the case.
They're coming for us.
We are. If we're not already, it's soon in the pipeline.
Oh, hell.
Hey, well, that was pretty good.
Yeah.
All right, we got to practice all of them.
Streamlab, thank you for the pile of Pam's 13.
Hey,
Pam's
13. Welcome. Pam's.
Pam's. Better than just a Pam. It's
no.
Pam's.
Now,
Pam's.
Is that I am the Pam?
Pam's.
I am Pam. I need to sleep a little
Pam's.
Bit.
Pam's.
Pam loves her Z's times 13. All right, so exactly 13 sleeps is what Pam needs. If my math is correct, which it always is.
He who toots his own horn.
Like, I control the stream deck.
One.
All right? And so, yeah, exactly. Look, a laugh track, it's everybody laughing. That's what I say.
Oh, yeah, we should put one of those in, too.
All those LaBeoufs.
Those LaBeoufs need a laugh.
In the background.
They're too serious. They
all the
LaBeoufs
of the world.
Well, Pam's. You've joined us just in time because we were about to sign off.
Yeah.
if we don't have any more calls, if anybody wants to have another spin, this is your chance. All right. If not, we will be back, of course, next Friday at 8:30. It might just be me. Yeah. If McConadilla's around, I'll drag him.
I'll be here
out,
doing my Gary Beauty.
I'll make my way out to. Let's see. We're in Costa Mesa now. Where would that be? I wonder.
Well, I know you have a long day at work, but if you can make it home in time.
Right. Where would that be?
Check it out, McConadilla.
What bullshit town?
McConadilla. I perfected the Beauty. Look.
We'll figure something out.
This is gonna win me an Oscar.
All right. That's
you ready?
It. That's it.
We ready?
One more time.
Okay. Oh yeah, of course.
Dun dun dun. Yeah, no, that's good. I think, all right.
You can win Oscars with that? With your teeth being all weird? You can't handle the tooth.
Gary Busey
you can't handle the tooth.
Starring Kirby.
Did he win for that? He should have.
Kirby Surf Squash.
That was a dramatic trial. Oof. I still get chills.
Chills.
Yeah.
All that Aaron Sorkin rotten just running through your veins.
Well, hey everybody, I'm gonna do my Michael Jackson hat real quick.
Yeah.
All right, and I'm gonna talk.
You bad?
I'm gonna
you
talk
bad?
Like a Florida alligator with the knife in my head. Now I was last Tuesday. I was swimming along the canal when a local street tough walked up to me when they said, "Hey, Mr. Alligator.
Hey, Mr. Psh.
I got some toast here on my satchel,
got
but
some toast
I got no butter."
What's happening?
I need some
I'm
butter,
out
Mr.
His thing.
Alligator.
What's happening right now?
And I said,
shh.
Oh, well,
is
I just.
Is this a virus?
Shh. I just.
Is this a virus?
I just happened to have some butter right here in my satchel. And so I pulled out the butter and he said, sack! And he stabbed me in the head with his knife. He did. Shh. He stood up dead. And I'm swimming along the canal and I'm an alligator with a knife in my head.
Yeah, you are.
That's what I is.
That's what you are.
What's happening?
That's what I is.
Takes hold.
Yeah. Wow. Maybe I need to wrap things up.
What? Yeah.
You're the host now.
Look.
What do you think?
Look, I got issues. It was my segment into mental health and the importance of getting checked out. All right. It was a PSA I was trying to do for the community. All right, Kirby. Jesus. Now look where
did
we
he
are.
Hear?
Did
he bring a pizza?
The alligator?
No.
Pizza.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus always brings pizza.
Yes. Thank you, Ohohokus.
Dang, what church you go to?
The more you know. All right, everybody. I hope
the
you learned something.
The Church of Dahamano.
Dahamano.
The Church of Dahamano.
Is there an apostrophe? Is that
Dahamano? Dahamano.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's Far East thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So,
bye, y'all.
Thank you for joining us, Ohohokus.
Have a nice, I hope y'all are right side of the snap this next week.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a big
don't
game
get the beer
Sunday.
Virus.
Stay safe out
it's
there.
A big game, everybody. Have a nice weekend.
And Ron, thanks for joining us.
Bye.
Chance Danger. Let's see who else we had out there. Let's call Anxious Allie Miles.
Love you, Allie.
Thank you so much for joining us. Mwah. Wabba Plays, Mwah. Of course, for the big Mwah. Chill. Much
thanks,
appreciated.
Steve.
To Wabba
thanks,
Plays.
Steve. Back to you, Jeff.
Who else we got up there? Steve, thanks for joining us.
Back Widget, to you, Jeff.
Widget and Pop Top,
Widget
thanks
Pop Top
so much.
For the video.
And Stream Elements, thanks as always for your auto notifications.
Yeah.
Couldn't do it without
ooh,
you.
Baby.
All right, everybody.
All right, have a good night, everybody.
We'll
bye.
See you next week. Bye.
Bye.